Hi dear students, how are you all of you? You all are very 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 warmly welcome on our YouTube channel. Dear student, this is our lesson number second, the sun, the moon and the earth. See dear students, lesson number one is already uploaded on our channel, okay? And to get more videos of geography standard 7, please subscribe our channel and please see this video at the end, then only you will understand the sun, the moon and the earth. Yes, see, okay, just I will zoom it. The moon's motion. Dear student, from standard 4 we have understood about the moon, yes, the earth and the sun, how the earth rotating around the sun, okay, how revolution of the earth, rotation of the earth. These are the things we have learned, but here in deep we are going to understand the motion of the moon, the earth. Yes, sun doesn't move, so motion of the moon and earth only. Like the earth, the moon also has axial and orbit motions. See how the earth has the orbit motion, the same moon it also has. The moon, while rotating around itself, revolves around the earth and the earth revolves around the sun. See, this is the change, dear student. Moon is revolving around the earth, okay, as well as earth is, you know, revolving around the sun. Yes, as a result, though the moon does not revolve around the sun independently, indirectly it makes revolution around the sun. See dear student, moon is revolving around the earth and earth is revolving around the sun. So what is the understanding here? Moon, it doesn't move around the sun independently, but indirectly it makes around the sun. Yes, it makes revolution around the sun because the moon, it's moving around the earth. It's very easy. Around the earth and one rotation around itself is the same. See, around the earth and the one rotation around itself, it is the same. That is why we constantly see one and the same side of the moon. And because of that, we see the one and the same side of moon. Yes? Now let's go next. Think about it. Like sunlight and moonlight, is there anything called the earthlight? If yes, where do you think it is found? Dear student, answer of this question you have to comment me. Okay, so I will get the common understanding of you. Now one experiment is given here. See, try this. Carry out this activity on a playground. See, on playground we have to go with the students. It's very easy. Okay, select 3 students. How many students we have to take? 3 students. Give them the role of sun, the moon and the earth. What role we have to give? One will be the moon, one will be the earth, one will be the sun. Make the sun stand in middle. Sun will be the middle. Okay, see the title page and we have to see the title. Okay, draw an elliptical orbit around the sun and we have to draw orbit around the sun. The student who has been given the role of the earth should rotate around himself from west to east, and the role which the child got, he has to move around himself. Okay, he has to rotate around himself. Simultaneously, he would revolve around the student who is the sun along the down orbit and anti-clockwise direction. In anti-clockwise direction, the earth, who is the boy earth, he has to move around himself, he has to rotate around himself, as well as he has to rotate around the sun. Sun means what? One of the boy, we are doing here activity. One of the boy, around him he has to rotate anti-clockwise. Make sure that the student who is performing the role of moon is also revolving around the one who is acting as the earth. And we have to make sure that who is the earth, means who is the moon, the boy, the student. Okay, we have to make sure when Earth is moving around the sun, so at the same time moon, the boy who is doing the role of moon, he also has to move around the Earth. Draw a diagram of the whole activity in your notebook, and this activity you have to draw in your notebook. That will be your task to do. Now, geographical explanation. The moon's orbit of revolution is also elliptical as that of the Earth. See, the moon's orbit, the revolution of the Earth, it is elliptical as the that of the Earth. Hence, the distance of the moon from the Earth is not same. See, the distance between Earth and moon, it is not the same. Let's come on the next page. Everywhere along its orbit while revolving. When moon is revolving around the Earth, the distance it is not same, orbital distance, when it is revolving. When it is the closest to the Earth, it is said to be a perigee. See, when the moon is nearest to the Earth, it is said that perigee, and when it is the farthest, the position is called apogee. Apogee. Yes, apogee, edge, and perigee. These are the things. Here we are going to observe figure 2.1, moon's position. Dear student, your homework is that you are going to draw this figure in your notebook. Yes. Now, you have studied the phases of moon. See, dear student, sometimes we are understanding the phases of moon. You know how it waxes from the new moon day to the full moon day, and how it wanes from the full moon to the new moon day. Dear student, see, these are the things we have. See, full moon day means Purnima. We have full moon day. On this Purnima, there is a full moon in at the night. Yes. New moon day is also there. See, these are the Purnima and Amavasya that we have. Yes. And we are observing also the phases of the moon. Yes, this moon, is it, no, it's the small semicircle, then it's becoming big. These are the phases we have observed. See, here in this picture also you can see different the phases of the moon. Yes. Now we are going to understand see figure 2.2, which shows the different phases of the moon. Dear student, we have observed this figure 2.2, and different phases of the moons are also given here. It shows the relative position of the moon on both the quarters, the full moon and the new moon day, with respect to the Earth and the Sun. See, dear student, here in these phases, what do we understand? The full moon day and new moon day, and the phases, how does it get the changes with the sun days, sunlight. Now think about it. Figure 2.2 shows the position of the moon as seen from the space and as seen from the Earth. How will you identify which are which? See, answer of this question, dear student, please comment me. Yes, I will tell you whether it is wrong or it is right. Now let's go on page number 3. It is also very nice, dear student. We will now continue with this page number 3. Now this is new moon day. Page number 3 we have covered. This is the page number 4. Can you see it clear? See, dear student, here they have given figure 2.3, angles made by the Earth, Moon, Sun. Angles are given, and these are the made by the Earth. This is the Earth, Moon, and the Sun is given. Yes. Now let's understand. Now 2.3, angles made by the Earth, Moon, Sun. We see the phases of moon in sky from the Earth.
Yes, dear student.
From where we are looking this moon? From the earth. They are the illuminated portions on the moon. These are the illuminated portions. Yes, they become visible due to the sunlight reflected from the moon. Yes, at the night we see that the sunlight, moon has the light, but from where does the moon get light? From the sun. Okay, it is the reflection. While revolving around the earth, the moon is on the opposite side of the sun on full moon day. See, while revolving around the earth, where is the moon? It is on the opposite side of the sun when a full moon day. Yes, whereas on a new moon day, it is positions between the sun and the earth. And at new moon day, it is where? It is positions between the sun and the earth. On the first and the third quarters day, the moon, the earth and the sun make an angle of 90 degree. It's very, very, very important, dear student. First and the third quarter days, the moon, the earth and the sun, which angle they are making? 90 degree, right angle. Okay, at these positions we see half the portion of illuminated moon. See, and at this day, the half lighted portion, I can say illuminated means at the half moon there we'll see the light. Hence in the sky it appears semicircle in shape. See figure 2.3. Here we are going to see figure 2.3. Okay, just a minute. See, half of the circle. Yes, it is dark and half of the circle it is illuminated. Here, moon is that. This is the earth. Yes, the same. Okay, understood this? Dear students, here we are going to understand eclipse. Yes, see, we are calling it in Marathi Grahan. Yes, we have eclipses. The orbital path of the earth and that of the moon are not in the same plane. See, the orbital path of the earth and that the moon, they are not in the same plane. The moon's revolutionary orbit makes an angle of about 5 degree with that of the earth. Yes, which angle does it making? About 5 degree with that of the earth. As a result, the moon interests the plane of the earth's orbit twice during one revolution. What does it happen, dear student? See, here the moon, it interests the plane of the earth's orbit twice during one revolution. On each new moon day, the lines joining the earth and the sun and the moon make an angle of 0 degree, whereas on each full moon day. What happened on each full moon day? The earth, the moon and the sun, they are making 0 degree. Okay, now this angle of 180 degree, even so the sun, the earth and the moon may not be in one straight line, is the same plane on every. See, the sun, the moon, the earth and the moon, they may not be in one straight line. Yes, in the same plane on every new moon or full moon day. Yes, every new moon day or full moon day, they are not in the same way. So, hence eclipses do not occur on each new moon or full moon day. Because of that, this eclipse, it doesn't occur on each full moon day. Sometimes it's happen, not always. Yes. Now, however, sometimes on a new moon day or a full moon day, the three fall in one line and are in the same plane. They are not कमिंग इन अ स्ट्रेट लाइन ऑलवेज इन ईच न्यू मुंडे और ईच फुल मुंडे बट समटाइम्स दे कम eclipses occur on such occasions and at that time there is the eclipse may be solar or lunar eclipse it may be solar or it may be lunar means the moon yes we have surya grahan and chandra grahan these are that is that clear dear student here you can see figure 2.4 angles between the planes of orbit already I have explained it to you you can see you will understand it by looking the figure also now think about it consider the relative positions of the sun the moon and the earth on new moon day and both the quarters what we have to consider relative positions okay of what of the sun the moon and the earth on new moon day and both the quarters what will be the angle between the lines joining the earth the moon as well as earth and the sun okay how many times will this angle be formed in a month that answer dear student you are going to comment me in a comment box okay this is our first video first part I am making here in the second part I am going to explain you solar eclipse dear student please see it you will be understood know this lesson okay thank you